Although the paths through the lofty peaks of Jueyun Karst are arduous, there are always bright-eyed mortals who come seeking the Adeptal Path. For all their ambition, most mere mortals cannot fathom the way to the Adepti, and return from their fruitless journeys disappointed. Yet those fortunate enough to encounter some hardship may suddenly find themselves being rescued by a divine young lady. Stunned by the elegance of their silver-haired savior, they hastily begin bowing excitedly in reverence and adulation, only to find their Adeptus rescuer remain indifferent and leave without even a second glance.
I will do as you command.
Though Shenhe is often mistaken for an Adeptus, she is actually a mortal, albeit one who is an accomplished Adepti disciple. Being naturally gifted, and having learned polearm combat and various adeptal arts from her masters, exercising evil spirits is a mere trifle to her. Under her master's tutelage, Shenhe trained diligently, producing impressive results. When Shenhe is dispatched on a 20-hour expedition in Liyue, she will obtain increased rewards. Shenhe's normal attack can combo up to 5 strikes with her polearm, dealing physical damage. Shenhe's charged attack consumes a set amount of stamina to lunge forward, dealing damage to enemies in her path. When she casts Spring Spirit Summoning, Shenhe grants all nearby party members the Icy Quill effect, and deals cryo damage in different ways based on whether the skill is tapped or held. When tapped, Shenhe will rush forward with a Talisman Spirit, dealing cryo damage to enemies along her path. When held, Shenhe commands the Talisman Spirit to deal AoE cryo damage to surrounding enemies. When party members are affected by Icy Quill, normal, charged, and plunging attacks, elemental skills, and elemental bursts that deal cryo damage to enemies deal increased damage based on Shenhe's current attack. The Icy Quill's effect will be cleared once its duration ends, or after being triggered a certain number of times. When the skill is held rather than tapped, the effect lasts longer and can be triggered more times. When a party member with the Icy Quill effect deals an instance of cryo damage to multiple enemies, the effect is triggered multiple times, according to the number of enemies hit. The number of times Icy Quill's effect is triggered is calculated separately for each party member. After unlocking the talent Spirit Communion Seal, when Shenhe casts Spring Spirit Summoning, she grants additional effects to all nearby party members. Tapping the skill increases their elemental skill and elemental burst damage, while holding the skill increases their normal, charged, and plunging attack damage.
Cryo Incarnate!
Shenhe unleashes the power of the Talisman Spirit, allowing it to roam free, dealing AoE cryo damage. The Talisman Spirit then creates a field, which decreases the cryo and physical resistance of enemies within, and also deals periodic cryo damage to them. After unlocking the talent Deific Embrace, an active character within the AoE of Divine Maiden's Deliverance will gain a cryo damage bonus. Shenhe is fated to bear the curse of calamity. As cautioned by the Adepti, she is careful to avoid harming the innocent. But as for those with malicious intent, she is only too happy to put them in their place by giving them a taste of the Adepti arts. Shenhe's Spring Spirit Summoning is the core of her skill set, offering support to other Cryo Party members with the Icy Quill effect. In battle, proficient use of her elemental skills tap and hold effects allows Shenhe to shine by enhancing the party's attack capabilities. When energy is full, Shenhe unleashes her elemental burst, decreasing enemies' cryo and physical resistance, and creating the opportune moment to defeat the weakened enemies. Liyue Harbor is known as a bustling melting pot of a city, ready to welcome any and every lonely figure. But if Shenhe truly wishes to rejoin human society, there is much she will have to learn. Even I myself do not relish the solitary life I lead. When others are fortunate enough to meet a companion for their journey, I sincerely wish them the very best. After all, to this day, I hold that people should be authors of their own fate, both the crane ready to make peace with the past, and the beast with a grudge to bear, have the freedom to make their journey home.